What's going on, my Zach King copiers? Thanks for choosing this video to get some PowerDirector knowledge upside your head. If you use PowerDirector and you haven't subscribed to my channel, please consider clicking the subscribe button and clicking the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. A few weeks back, I showed you guys how to create a Zach King effect. Since you asked for more Zach King loving, you know I had to give it to you. Now, as I've been told many times before, I'm the PowerDirector Professor of Effects, and as your professor, I have no choice but to show you how to pull off this effect using PowerDirector. The most important part of this effect is the setup. You need to place your camera on a tripod and frame your shot so you can see the vehicle and the talent walking. Then you need to place a tripod in your shot. You need to place your tripod close enough to the camera to get the object that you want to place on top of it appear big in the shot. Tilt your tripod so it's aligned with the hood of your vehicle. Then you want to record the footage of your talent taking a stroll, you know, doing his thing, walking, and also placing the object on top of the tripod. Now, don't go in front of the tripod, because if you do, whatever goes in front of the tripod is going to be masked out of that shot. You want to record it, let it record for a while with the thing sitting on top of it. And when you're done, you want to go ahead and remove the object that you have from the tripod. And after you remove the object from the shot, continue recording. This way you will have a blank slate that you can use later on for the mask. Now that we're done with the setup, let me show you how to do this effect. First, you want to move your playhead to a point before the object is taken off of the tripod. And then once you get here, you want to do Control T to split your clip. Now you want to move your playhead to a position where you have a blank slate that you can use. And then you want to go ahead and click on the Snapshot button. You can choose a location where you want to put it. And then you want to go ahead and click on Save. And you're not going to need this end clip anymore, so you can left click on it and then do shift delete, and it'll go ahead and delete that. Now the snapshot is in your media library, so you want to left click on it, hold that left button down with your mouse, and drag it down below the footage of the recording that you made. Then you want to place your cursor at the end until you see two arrows pointing in opposite directions. Hold down your left mouse and drag it out so that it is the same length as the clip on top of it. Now you want to go ahead and use this snapshot to create a mask that's going to cover up the tripod so you can't see the tripod in the shot anymore. So you want to go ahead and left click on this clip. You want to go to Tools. And then you want to go to Mask Designer. So here we're going to go ahead and choose the square mask. And then you want to position it over the tripod. So if I move this over, you can see the tripod here. And you can see the shot of the actual object that I put on top of it. So we want to go ahead and remove that. So you can use your nodes and you can resize it. And go ahead and move it over. When you see the crosshairs, you can move it wherever you want. And of course, you're going to have to rotate it to make sure that it's actually going to be the same angle as your tripod. So I'm just doing a little rough edit here, and this is actually pretty good, but I know the parameters that I'm gonna use, so I'm just gonna go ahead and type those in. So I'm gonna start off with the scale here. And then I'm gonna go to the position that I want. And my rotation. And then once you get your mask placed exactly where you want it and how you want it, you can go ahead and click on OK. And now we can go ahead and play this back and see what it looks like. Now that's a big old jug of water. If you like what you see, I'll leave links to try PowerDirector for free and buy PowerDirector in the video description. Using those links helps to support the channel so I can make more content for you. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my cartoon face to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.